it's good to see you all. I came back from Japan last weekend, and then I worked like 3 days straight, and then I went to Comic Con, and then I came here. So like this is really nice. Like this is like. Speaking of, I brought some stuff from Comic Con that I want to give out to some lucky people. It's Ladybug Baby. You guys kind of like that show? So I don't know how I'm going to give these away yet, but I have the Comic-Con exclusive volume 1 or issue 1 of this new Ladybug comic. I have 4 of those.
Do a Ladybug musical episode was.
So before I like before voice acting work really picked up, I used to post on YouTube. And I became, like, a couple of videos were, like, really big. So I love singing. And I was in a couple of musical shows, but unfortunately with anime, it's really hard to license the music and translate it into English. It's very difficult. So when they said that there's a musical episode, I was just crossing my fingers that they would let the casting and not, you know, hire step singers. And they did. And I was so excited. And it's a dream come true. So I'm really glad I got to do that. Yeah, I loved it.
And so, do you mean they didn't hire a stunt singer for Bryce as well? Because I know that he hates singing, or he's bad.
He sang, yeah. Everybody sang their own parts.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Thank you.
1990s?
No, in the 1990s, I was 7.
I was thinking the original one. Was it Hasbro?
The original one was done here in Canada.
Yep.
And the voice actor for Sailor Moon is actually my favorite out of the show when I was watching it when I was a kid. Her name was Katie Griffin.
Okay, I thought that
Griffin?
Was...
Guys, you can correct me.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I thought that was you.
Oh, okay.
So you did the reboot.
Yeah, I did the reboot and the redub.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Who's your favorite character aside from Marinette and Ladybug?
In Ladybug, my favorite character... Oh, goodness. It used to be Nathaniel. He's sweet. I really, like, freaked out when they introduced Layla. Bobina. I like her. She's, like, mean and interesting. Yeah. Thank you. Hi.
Hi. So across any of the mediums, was there any particular character that was more difficult to voice act, something outside of your normal register that you found that you had to work a little bit harder towards to get closer to what the character you've been performing for?
So far, like, I feel like the most challenging role I've ever had is Kilua from Hunter Hunter. Because I voiced young boys before, but for him he's such an important character, and he's so loved by many people. So I feel like we really had to work hard to dial down the voice, and it even actually changed. If you listen to how it was in the beginning, it's almost completely different to how it is now. It's deeper and more, I guess, natural sounding. But he's the challenge every time. And again, I think it's also because I know, like, how important he is to people. So I want to make sure that every time I go in, I'm doing him justice.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi. You having watched Sailor Moon growing up, how does it feel now that you're voicing Sailor Mars yourself?
Oh, hey, can we close that door back there? Or not? No, a few more coming in that time. Hi, welcome.
Hi.
Welcome to Defense Against the Dark Arts. Especially the first year of being cast, it was like, is this gonna
am I going to get like new cast? What's going to happen? It seems so good to be true. And now it's really kind of become part of my identity. Like, it gives me a lot of strength when I think about like what I'm able to accomplish with voiceover, because that was literally, I wanted to be in theater when I was a kid, and I'm in it. In that same exact show now. So, yeah.
And one more, who's your favorite Sailor Moon character?
My favorite Sailor Moon character? Oh, herself. Did I hear somebody say 60? You know that. Because that would be 100% correct. No, you know, I love Sailor Moon. I think that she is by far, like, she gets the most action. I mean, you know what I mean? Like, she's the most developed, and she's a fun character.
Thank you. But what was your favorite episode to do, or what was your favorite episode in general?
So my favorite episode in Ladybug, did somebody just say you're welcome, and were you referencing like all those memes on YouTube? Because I was just introduced to the you're welcome memes, and in my life, that movie used to be so near to me. Now I just think of memes. So my favorite episode of Ladybug, I like to do the Origins episode. It felt really like I was interested, I wanted to see how it happened, and I got to play her a little bit differently, and like I said, growing up in Sailor Moon, I was, you know, I loved it, and so I felt like this was very much the closest to a Sailor Moon episode, like the reluctant transformation, and the what's going on, and it's so much fun, so those are my favorites. Oh, and then the umbrella scene at the end was my favorite scene. Do you know what? I had to keep that to myself for months. I saw that scene and I emailed Thomas, or I DM'd Thomas, the creator, like, that was so amazing! Oh my god! Like that, with all caps. And like 17 folks. Thank you.
Hi, Monica.
You said you voiced someone from Steven Universe, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What's your opinion on like the whole controversy with the style consistency and like character design consistency issues?
Oh, you know what? I unfortunately haven't kept up too much with it. I didn't know that was a thing. Okay. But what I will say is, you know, animation is not a science. You know, it's art, and you know, people are going to change. Staff is going to change, and you know, deadlines and all that stuff. You know, in the end, people are making a product, and you know, you just have to kind of roll with it, I guess. You know, but I'm gonna look into that. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
You too.
I will.
Hey again.
Hi.
Okay. First off, did you know that apparently my friend just sent this to me, but apparently there's a meme of me doing backflips, and apparently it's the dodgeball meme of me being Miraculous Ladybug.
Oh yeah?
It's weird. I'll show you next time. Okay. I also, blah, 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 blah. I'm trying to, whenever you are, like, voice acting, how do you get into the role?
So, for me, for voice acting, you know, there's, like, because I've been doing this for, like, exactly half my life. And so it becomes less about like the whole, and I am a classically trained actor, but it becomes a lot less about like the whole like book work and studying the scenes, because you don't have that. To be a voice actor, you have to be able to do it on the spot. So you have to be really good at improv and reading. It's actually a lot of reading. But I'm really informed by the visuals of the character, and you know, we have the audio track too, so that helps like shape the voice. And then there's the director who will be there to make sure that I'm being true to the character.
All right, cool. Thanks.
Thank you. All right, everybody, who wants a compliment? Okay, so we're going to do a trivia. So let's see. Yes?
Hi! Who does your hair?
Oh! Her name is Tanya. I can hook you up. She's awesome. Okay.
What's the land, the speed of an African Hopi pigeon?
What's the speed of what?
Okay. So.
Do science. Or you can see how.
No science.
I don't know this answer, but what was the first anime that you ever voice acted for?
That's a great one. What was the very first anime I ever voice acted in? And I'll give you a hint, I wasn't even a character, I was Walla.
What? A what?
Yes.
Lemon.
Yes! Crazy! So Walla is, you're in a group of people and you just do the background voices for like the group scenes, and that's what I did with my very first session with my staff. So cool. All right. Here you go. Thank you. Good knowledge there. All right. Do we have any more questions? Stuff. Yeah. Right over here.
What's your favorite character in Hunter?
My favorite character in Hunter. Kiowa. And I'm not even biased. He's just so like interesting and cool, and I love him. Like when I was reading for him in the audition, I was like, these other characters are cool, but he's awesome. And I'm looking forward to meeting Aluka, his brother sister. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I have hopes that Christine will voice that character. I really want that to happen. So proud of me. Yeah, play great character. Yeah. Awesome. And yeah.
Sorry, this is a silly question. You asked this for me. I'm assuming that you're in Greed Island by now. It's like, so what's your opinion on like how Hisoka treats the boy?
Hisoka's interesting. I think he makes the show really interesting and
he's amazing.
I don't trust that guy in English. But he does an amazing job at voicing him. So yeah. A good character. Who wants a picture? Look at everybody's like, should I raise my hand? Okay. Here's one. No Googling. What is Sailor Mars' attack in Sailor Moon Crystal Season 3? Can we have one?
Oh,
yeah.
Wait, did you say Season 3 or Season 1?
Season 3. No. And you have to shout it out too. Yes.
Fireman Dalla, right?
It is not. In Crystal. Sailor Moon Crystal Season 3. Sailor Moon Crystal Season 3, Sailor Mars was attacked. You can Google it.
Who's the
connection of the best? Okay.
Sailor.
Nobody has the answer? We'll go on to the next question. It was Mars Fire Snake.
Oh, I was just looking up. I just got that.
Okay, here's one that you will not know. Who was my very first starter Pokemon and my very first Pokemon game ever? Oh, I saw Team Squirtle's hand picked up. It wasn't. In the back with the red.
Pikachu!
That's so! Yes, it was. Power of Deduction.
Nice.
Poor Bulbasaur. So, I started playing Pokemon like Red and Blue. I think like most of you are too young for that.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, guys, it was so hard back then, to get everything like. Even the HMs, you have to do all these crazy things, and it's so hard.
So I had to one go.
So, I always take the grass types because of my nostalgia. All right, let's do more questions. Yes, way in the back.
Okay, I have two questions.
Sure.
Who do you think Cosmos is? I really think that's Adrian's dad.
Yes! Oh,
Revealed? It wasn't.
It's still just speculation, I think.
Really? Oh, maybe I'm not going to say anything then. I know exactly who it is. No rush. Yes, right up front.
What do you do with your free time when you're not voice acting?
With my free time?
Yeah.
I like to read a lot. I have a dog, a corgi.
Aww.
She's 7 years old. I had her since she was 7 weeks old. So our corgo human strong and bond is strong. I like hanging out with her. I hang out with my friends a lot. Cristina Valenzuela is like my best friend. I'm making more music these days. So yeah, like I do quiet things. Like I've never really been a person who goes like out on the town or whatever, you know, I'm very introverted. Those are what I like to do. Thank you. Yeah, right here and right there.
What are you currently reading and what's your favorite book?
Ooh, those are good questions. Right now, I just started on Handmaid's Tale. And one of my these are my two books that I would recommend to you guys. The first one is Ready Player One, which is amazing. Read it before the movie comes out, so you can still be a cool hipster, like me. And there's another book called Carry On, The Rise and Fall of Simon Snow. Have you guys heard of that? Oh my gosh, guys, it is so good. If you like Harry Potter, read it. So, it's by an author, maybe your author name is Rainbow Rowell, and she's just amazing. Yes, she's so good. And so, in this version of the whole wizarding school, mage school, I guess, the main character, Simon Snow, has a rival named Baz, and he's a vampire. And they may or may not be in love with each other secretly. And it is so good. It's just one book. Please read it. Sign me know. So good. Thank you.
What's the name of your puppy?
My puppy? Her name is Yellow Gray Happiness Layouti Samshank Lehoxman Barman. So I call her Brave for short. Every time she has a new name, it's because I have an urge to get another pet. And so I just give her a new name. It's a hard name to say, what's your dog name? Gallifrey? What? Frank? Yes, Frank. we call her Frank for short. She's such a sweetheart. She's a good dog. She goes boom. Yes.
Voice development from this area, by any chance?
Okay, so this is something that you should not do as a voice actor. But as you know, Violet's voice is very deep. My voice does not naturally sit there. So what we would do first is, because once you scream, if you scream, your voice is going to get tired and drop. So what we would do is, after the first session, we realize that if I start off with the lines, eventually the voice is just going to get deeper and deeper as we go on the session. So what we did was we started every session with screaming. And that is the opposite, the complete opposite of what voice actors do. But because I know how to not strain my voice, because I know the proper technique, I would do it, right? Because no matter how trained you are, if you scream, it's gonna make your voice tired. So I would scream first. And that's how we got that super deep tone of Velvet, where it's just in the back of the throat all the time. And it was just so much fun. I was really happy when I heard that I was going to be that character. Thank you. Yes.
Do you agree that home run did nothing wrong?
Do I agree that home run did nothing wrong? Home run didn't do anything wrong! She has very special circumstances. She has emotions nobody else has ever experienced because she was looping in time. So you can't really blame her. It's all Cubic's fault. What a
Okay, so you keep saying that you prefer characters with deep development.
Yeah.
Is there any character in Miraculous Ladybug you want to see developed further?
Ooh, further developed character than Ladybug. Well, I think somebody who really needs a character arc is Chloe. Especially if she's going to have a bee miraculous, you know? Yeah. Like, I want to see how she gets that, what kind of person she's going to be once she has that responsibility of being a superhero. And I think that's going to be really interesting, and I kind of feel like I wouldn't mind a Sailor Mars, Sailor Moon type relationship with those two characters. So I'm looking forward to that. Yeah, thanks. Alright, I saw a hand over here. Hi!
Who's your favorite character in
Maki? In Maki? I really like, is his name Hakuryu? With the scar?
Oh.
Rap?
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked his character, played by Daryl. I liked the character arc that, you know, he proposed to Morgiana. And I want to see what happens. Because before that, I was really like, oh, she's going to end up with Alibaba. And after that, like, no, she's going to become a princess. So, yeah. Thank you. All right, so, over here.
I was just wondering, because a lot of, the miraculous book endings is kind of, split on this, but.
Yeah.
What's your opinion about, Thomas is, no spoiler man, he doesn't want spoilers ever, but
yeah.
Jeremy tends to stuff a lot early.
Oh, yeah?
What's your opinion with that? If you have one.
Interesting. Okay, so the question was, one of the creators of Ladybug, leaks stuff super early, and the other one doesn't want anything to be spoiled. You know what? I'm in the camp where I want everybody to find out things at the same time. So, I know, when I go into a movie and stuff, I don't want to know what happens. I like to be surprised. It's a lot rarer these days because, the internet and, mass sharing of, information and stuff, so I completely understand it. So I think a little spoiling is okay, but mainly, I don't even watch trailers to movies I'm looking forward to because I do not want to see anything. So that's the camp I'm in. Thank you. All right, let's take a quick, very quick question break and give away another comic book.
Okay.
Sound good? All right. What is my dog's name?
Oh,
I saw your hand up first. Yeah.
Right.
Yes. No. Come on. I kind of feel like I would become a dark magical world, so
would probably be like a side. Yeah, I think it would probably be something like pretty good, TBH. I'm pretty dark, so. Yeah, it would have to be like something like kind of like a melee, a close weapon with magic. So, yeah. Like you cut off their arm and it goes to another dimension or something cool.
And you wonder why your friends think you're a Slytherin?
Exactly. Slytherin. Alright. And right here, yeah.
Here's a test question.
Yes.
Okay. You say you don't like spoilers?
Yeah.
And then do your script. Do you sneak to the end to see what happens, or do you read the whole thing first?
I can't. We don't get scripts.
Or the lines.
We, and it's on a TV screen, so we can't really scroll ahead, it's all just the director. So literally, if you read a line for the first time, you can't like read ahead or anything, it's just, this is the page, this is what's going on, and then, you know?
Do they
read ahead?
Is there like...
Oh, they tell me like everything I need to know, like if something happens, big happens, like for Homura, I had to watch the series because there was, yeah, I had to know why she was the way she was. So when it comes to like shows that I'm in, I definitely want to be as informed about the character as I can, because you can't really take, if there's something huge like that, you can't really just chance that you're making the right choice, especially if the information's available. So yeah, thank you. All right, let's go over here.
What's your favorite art and also scene voicing for?
My favorite arc.
Scene.
I don't know why, and again, this is like the Slytherin thing, but it was really interesting when he was being tortured by his brother. Sorry, everyone. Because it was just like, wow, this is like his family dynamic, and it's so twisted and messed up. But again, it shows so much about his character that he was just like.
Do you like the part when he was getting tortured, or the part where he was told that?
The whole everything, because like it just shows his strength of character, like he was able to just endure it. But then you see like how much he really does care about his friends, and I think it's really touching. And it was good. So yeah, thanks. And Team Skull, and then I'll go to Blue.
Do you have any shiny Pokemon?
You know what? I don't. I'm really bad. Okay, here's what I do with all my Pokemon games. I beat them and then I trade them in. I'm sorry. I live in LA, so I have very minimal space. So I've had to learn to like let go of things. Besides, when I was a kid playing Pokemon on Game Boy, not even Game Boy Color, just Game Boy, I got a Game Genie and I had like 300 hours logged, and I had like this Venusaur that I was in love with because he was my friend, and I dropped it while the Game Genie was in, and I lost all my data. And that made me learn the hard way, like, don't get too attached to your pixelated creatures. You just gotta let them go. So that's my origin story. That's why I am the way I am today. All right, we should end it.
All right, so I have two questions.
Sure.
Do you think Adrian and her next identity revealed in season 2 of The Miraculous Ladybug?
Season 2? You know what? I don't know, but I really hope so, because I feel like after that hurdle is cleared, we can at least face for a lot more interesting developments, and maybe even some love triangles, and maybe, you know, maybe Marinette will fall in love with somebody else. I don't know. I haven't seen any of the scripts, but yeah, I'm just interested to see how they will react if they know who they are in IRL. So, yeah. We got to read a script actually for season 2 at Comic-Con. And, Adrian, you're such a cinnamon. So, in this script, and it's not really a spoiler, like, there's a TV, a camera crew at Marianne's house, and they're broadcasting live, and they go into her room and broadcast, like, Marianne's pictures of Adrian, and Adrian sees it. And you know what he says?
Nah, she's just a good friend.
Yeah.
My favorite magical girl show? Ooh, that's a good one. I can't say Mono, but can I? My favorite magical girl show.
You mean Power?
I think Mono best. Hey! Yeah, it's great. I always show, like, that's my gateway anime that I show to people. Like, just watch Mono. Do you guys have Netflix up here?
Yep.
Yeah. But we don't get the same shows as the US.
You don't get the same shows? Do you guys get like Ajin and... Do you get Dance Zero? Or Dance Other? Oh, I see. Because I do a lot of like cool anime like that's released on Netflix first. I was wondering if you guys know about it. Like Blom or Glam? Flame? Yeah, so it's Blaine, exclamation point, exclamation point. I found out, when I was in Japan, I visited their studio, we went to a bunch of their shows, and I found out how it's pronounced. And this is the correct pronunciation of that show. It's Blam. It's supposed to be like the death of a gunshot. Blam. So, spread the word, tell your friends. Yes. Let's give away another comic book. Watch it, but...
No!
You guys don't seem too excited. Okay. In Tales of
Berseria...
Oh, God. Exactly right. What is the name of the person I want to kill?
Hi!
Oh, up front.
Artorias.
Yes, you're right. And also characters that have like
huge emotional breakdown. It was really fun. Thank you. If I can make my own miraculous based off a platypus! It'd be so interesting! Yeah! What would my power be? I'd be able to like spit venom.
Be a secret agent?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd be a secret agent. One platypus. That's my favorite animal after my dogs. Alright, yes, over here. In TV Universe, I voice my character in the Human Zoo episode. Do you know that is? Her name is Jay Ken. And I'm also like the voice in the earrings who was like, now reach up to the sky and breathe. That character. Let's do it. Yeah. Thanks. All right. Oh, right here. Yeah. Hi.
So, I know you mentioned you wanted more Monica to see where on our road there. Are there any other characters you'd like to voice again that you might not get a chance to?
I would like, there's so many, like Familiar Zero. I would love to finish off the series with Louise. I mean, that was like 10 years ago now, holy cow. When I was more Gianna than Maggie, I feel like we did get to see what happened to her in the second season. Like, she kind of just disappeared, and I was pretty bummed out about that. Who else? I hope that Velvet keeps coming back.
Yes.
You know, like, making cameos and future games. Who else? Oh, Hop the Pig. I love him so much.
You will get a chance for that one. There's more season than movie.
That's right. I heard there's like a new season and a movie coming out. I'm so excited. Oh, speaking of movies, I'm going to be in the new fairy tale movie. So please watch it when it comes out. I know what you mean. Oh, did you guys hear about that like Resident Evil and Dead movie?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm like the bad guy in that. That was really exciting. Like she's bad, and she's Spanish, so I got to speak in like my accent, and it was just fun. And have you guys played the Friday the 13th, the video game?
Yes.
Play it. I guess you maybe like save me or murder me, whatever you want. Yeah, I did like some fun things this past year. Okay, let's go right here. Let's come back here.
What other game have you played besides Pokemon?
What other game?
Yeah.
Animal Crossing was very important to me. Oh my goodness. Hyrule Warriors is big for a while. Mainly like Nintendo stuff, to be honest. Like I love like Yoshi's Woolly World and what was another big PS game that I was playing for a while? I don't know. Pokemon Go, remember like last year in July, like everyone was playing Pokemon Go and the world was all perfect. I missed that. That was really fun. Like we were in Hawaii, like all the cool kids, and everybody was playing Pokemon Go. My favorite game, and people always give me poop about it, is Zelda Ocarina of Time. Yes. Does anybody not know who that is? Gundam Wing.
Okay, so again, in Japan, I went to the Gundam Cafe to get the Gundam Wing exclusive merchandise. I paid $40 for this amazing t-shirt, and I don't really like usually wear like anime t-shirts, but this one was so good. It had like all of my Gundam boyfriends on it. And I lost it in Akihabara, like when I was shopping for tail stuff, and like nobody turned it in. Of course, I mean, it was like, you know, limited edition, it was the last one, and I was just so sad. I'm so sad that I lost that. You're right, I had to move on. It was the teacher saying, move on, you're a 14-year-old kind of boy. So I love Japan. It's a very, especially from like, because I live in LA, always live in LA, and people there just, everybody's like, it's about the individual. Like, I gotta get ahead. You're in my way. I should be on this train first. But in Japan, everybody is like, don't get me wrong, there's like a rush, but everybody is like so focused on getting where they're going, like they don't talk into people. If they do, like, I'm so sorry. It's more of just like it's so, I don't want to say polite, but it's just more, I don't know, it's great. It's more human in a way. Sorry, Los Angeles, but yeah, because everybody thinks about the whole, you know, instead of just the individual, and that's something I'll really miss. And it was great to speak Japanese, because I don't have like that chance here. Yeah, some of those places, like, I feel like if I didn't love my job so much, I could probably just live there, and I wouldn't even bat an eye. This is great. Yeah, but as for what we did, I just thought like my I just like went shopping for all my new stuff, like all day every day. And I got like I went to Harajuku, bought like some really cool clothes, and we just walked around, and we got really sick. So that kind of sucked. But on my birthday, we went to Tokyo DisneySea. And the next day I went back to Tokyo Disneyland by myself, and that was my first time doing that, going there and by myself. And it was, again, it was just great. Like, we watched the electrical parade, and nobody, like, stood up. Everybody was just seated the entire time, so you could see everything always, and it was just so good. I miss it. I love to have such few things. Thank you. All right, I saw a hand over here. Yes?
What character are you voicing in the new fairy tale movie?
I'm voicing a character named Swan. She has purple hair, which of course is my typecast. So yeah, she's cool. She's really fun. Yes.
I like asking voice actors this question.
Sure.
Do your voices come out in public?
My voice? No.
Your voices come out in public. If you're at a certain setting or something, all of a sudden.
You know, I don't feel like I usually do that. Like I
know some do.
Yeah, I just like making big noises, but I don't think that's and I do like make like Christine too, like we make sound effects without even knowing it, and people kind of are like, wait, okay. But it's just more, I don't feel like I put on voices for people. A lot of times because, you know, my voice is really just me, my regular voice. And I feel like once I'm in the booth, I'm in a different mindset, you know, in work mode. And usually when I'm, like, not working, like, even when I'm here, I try to just focus on, like, other stuff. Because, like, so much of my life is, like, auditioning and working and then, you know, so, yeah. Thank you so much. All right.
You have about 5 more minutes, right?
All right, so I'm going to go to somebody who hasn't asked a question yet. Have you?
No. Oh, I already
did. Did you?
I did.
Okay, yeah.
Have you been to anywhere else in Canada, and what do you like about Canada?
Ooh, anywhere else in Canada? I've been to Victoria Island. That was my first time. It was beautiful. And I went to Victoria in Edmonton. And I love it here, guys. So nice. Like I said, I live in LA, so it's like the epitome of like the US and
all the smog.
There's lots of smog. It's like the smog and like the traffic. because I lived there my entire life. So that's what I'm used to. So it's really refreshing to come here, and it's kind of like very much like Japan, just people are more like open with each other, where at home, like, people aren't. So you guys have a good thing going here. And Justin Trudeau, I really like him, so good job. GG, GG. So, yeah, I love Canada. A lot, a whole lot. I love coming up here. Thank you. Alright, so, wait, oh, yeah. In the back of the red shirt?
Oh, shit.
Well, I just answered that. My name is Juan.
Do you classify
Ahsoka
as a villain or an anti-hero?
Oh, at first, that's a good question. At first, I thought he was a villain. But then, like, the whole Green Island Park thing happened, and now I'm more like, who he? So, that's interesting. Thank you. And in the back was the zip of black jacket. Yes. My favorite thing to voice act in Manuka. So I don't know if this was my favorite thing, but it was the most difficult and most memorable. But it's during like the entire episode, I think it was episode 8, where Homura is revealed, like her backstory. There were scenes in there that really hit me hard, like especially because it's Christine in my headphones, and you know, all this time where they are going to turn into witches. Like, those were really powerful. So heartbreaking. And thank you. All right, over here.
Can you say a quote from the book with your very
head? You want me to say a quote? What quote do you want me to say? Thank you. 2 more minutes. Who has an who's like, oh, are you Zoro or a fan version? Yeah, cool.
That would be just amazing. That showed me a whole lot to me.